بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his entire household, all his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them all and to bless every single one of us and to grant us goodness and ease in this world and the next. My brothers and sisters, everyone is in search of contentment. Everyone wants to be happy. Everyone would like to smile. Each person would like whatever would make their lives easy to be achieved by themselves. But the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is such that He does not give you everything you wish for and everything you want. And He makes you and I go through what we term as hardship. It is difficulty. Sometimes it is calamity. Sometimes it is to the degree that we begin to crack. However, if we look at it from the angle of a believer, if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you believe in the last day, and you believe in the fact that this world is temporary, then it would make life much easier for you, and you would achieve that contentment in a very, very short period of time. How is this possible? Say, for example, a person's life was very simple, very easygoing, and suddenly hardship came in the form of perhaps a medical issue, something in your body, something physical that affected you, and suddenly you lost sleep because you became worried. And perhaps you might have visited the doctors, and maybe the doctors may have helped you initially. Perhaps they may not have been able to help you. Maybe you might have run out of money in some cases to pursue the medical solutions for that particular problem that you may have. So that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants you to realize He is in control. He wants you to know that every single person will ultimately leave this temporary world. It is so temporary. Do not get excited by what you see around you. Always be focused by where you are heading. Or always be focused upon where you are heading, so that you remember the difficulties of life. Even if you take what you want, and look at others who have it, they are also not happy. Say, for example, today, living in this country, Zimbabwe, we do know that there is a challenge of an economic nature where everyone is going through some form of economic hardship. Even those who were wealthy, they have had to downgrade their lives to a certain extent. Some of those who are unable to downgrade their lives, they are less happy than those who were poor from the very beginning. So if you have a person who was poor from the very beginning, they have had a tough life, they are happy with a little bit of food, perhaps an avocado that grows in the tree, and perhaps something else. If they were happy with that, they will always remain happy. But for those who are used to meat and chicken and fish and roast and lamb and leg and so on every day, the day they get vegetables, they are very upset. They cannot sleep at night. What happened? I've got a big problem. I haven't had meat for 1 week. My brother, there are people who haven't had meat for 2 years. What are you talking about? They are happy. They are delighted. They lead their lives thanking Allah for the potatoes that they've been having. Subhanallah. So to adjust is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are not ready and prepared to adjust your life, to downgrade it, perhaps to sell your vehicle and buy one which is cheaper, perhaps to take your children out of a private school and put them into a government school, perhaps to seek medication from a government institution or hospital, perhaps to downgrade your life in the sense that you don't need the latest phone and you don't need the latest of everything and the perfumes. You just need something basic, simple, whereby you can live. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are not prepared to adjust your life, do not blame the Almighty for what you don't have. He has given you. He has given you your portion. He has given you what was yours and you are not happy with it. You want what someone else has. That is not good enough, because that person also wants what someone else who has more than him has. So this is something that is a never-ending circle. The only time it ends is when you believe in Allah and you are focused upon the fact that you are returning to Allah very soon. You find wealthy people, they also get sick. They also are on their deathbed. Some of them die quicker because maybe their eating habits might be not as good. I normally say those people who struggle with very high cholesterol, perhaps those people who struggle with some issues and problems, perhaps sometimes it is around the fact that their food or the way they eat, their eating habits are not healthy. Whereas if you have a poorer person who may not be able to afford all those types of foods that are very tasty, you will find that the food that is very tasty sometimes is unhealthy for you. Unhealthy. Here in this country, there is a belief that only wealthy people, they are the ones who eat pizza every day. I don't know if you've heard that. If you ask someone, what would you like? They would tell you pizza, which means that's the height of everything. In this country, for some reason, this is what we hear people say. Not realizing you cannot have that every day. It is unhealthy for you. Once in a blue moon, it's okay. But that amount of dairy product, that amount of cheese, that is actually, I'm sorry to say, junk food, if you were to look at it that way. It is something that is not nutritious. It is something that is just, by the way, perhaps, you know, a little snack or some fast food that you may want to have once in a while. Get used to eating proper food and thank Allah for that. It will be cheaper and better for you and healthier in every single way. So when we search for contentment, when we search for happiness, remember, Allah has given you that happiness. It is glaring you in the face, but you don't want to look at it. You want to look in another direction. Allah tells you, look, I took away half of your money. Now you are only worth half what you were last year. But I want you to get happiness and contentment by downgrading your life. You are not prepared to downgrade your life. Who are you blaming? Can you blame Allah for that? Allah says, I am testing you. I can test you in another way, by taking your limbs away, by taking your family members away, by taking something else away from you. But I am doing you a favor. Part of your test, it's a simple test. It's only that instead of eating meat 4 times a week, you can eat meat once a month. That's all. You are not ready to do that. Don't blame Allah. You are unhappy because you want to live a life higher than what Allah has chosen for you. I am not saying do not go out to earn. Go out and earn, but adjust your lifestyle according to the size of your pocket. Remember that. The problem with us, we are facing economic hardship. And on top of that, we want to live a life of luxury. We want the latest of phones, the latest of gadgets, the latest of perfumes, the latest of cars, the latest of everything. And then we blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to say, Allah has not provided for me. My brother, there are people who have nothing, literally nothing. They don't even know what they are going to eat tonight. And they are happy making the dhikr of Allah. They are smiling. They are with their families. They have a little bit of something, maybe peanuts. Literally, when I say peanuts, I'm talking of the nut, really. They sometimes have different types of nuts. They will boil them and they sit together as a family, have 10, 15 with a bit of water. They are happy, prepared for the next day. That I'm talking of this particular country. The problems we are facing are tremendous. We cannot deny them. But it's our duty to help each other to look at the positives. There are others who used to spread rumor that people are dying of hunger in this country. If they just mean that people are struggling, that may be correct. But if they mean people have died as in death, I don't believe that. And I don't think you believe that either. In a country like this where tomatoes can grow just as you throw a seed or spit it out of your mouth by mistake, they will grow out there. Or perhaps a small little bit of food, a little piece of bread, something keeping you surviving, water. The water table is not as far as other countries. You might want to get perhaps 20 meters going down on average, maybe sometimes 40, 60 and heading to 90, perhaps in an area where there is really no water. That is a gift compared to where the desert is. They don't even have any water. Take a look at the positives. Today, people make a plan. How do they make a plan? I give you an example of this masjid. And I'm sure there are people from outside the masjid who come here perhaps to fill water. Why? Because it's a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's coming from the ground. And mashallah, there is a well or a borehole. People are coming and getting. Nobody can say, we don't have water. We are very fast to complain. There's no electricity, no water. Look, if there is rationing of water and electricity, it's happening even in other countries. It's happening to our south as well. You all know that in South Africa, there are difficulties as well. They also struggle with power cuts and so on. In some areas, they don't have water and so on. So we perhaps might be going through greater difficulty, but it's been quite a while. At least we are beginning to make a plan. People have a battery, people have an inverter, people have a generator, people make a plan, they do something else. And this is how we are proceeding and progressing. So stop complaining about the situation. Start doing something about the situation. Doing something positive. Try and look at the positives. Because the reason I say this, my brothers and sisters, if we continue to complain, a complaint has never solved a problem. We would sit and say, right guys, today we're having a big meeting. Everyone must come and complain. And we all complain 3,000 complaints. Does that sort your electricity problem? Does that sort your water problem? Will that suddenly bring, you know, food dropping from the heavens and saying, right guys, here you are, eat? It doesn't. But if you go out, you work, you do something, you try, you know, you save electricity. We have a problem also. Some of us who do have water, we waste it without realizing. The way we bath. Some of us who have access to a shower, when the water is there, we say, oh, now that the water is there, let's switch it on. And we're standing under the shower and we are waiting and we are busy counting sheep under the shower. Doing what? Subhanallah. You don't have to do that. You turn on the tap. Once your body is wet, subhanallah, you turn it off. You might want to soap it up. You turn it on again. You wash the soap off and you turn the water off and you are gone. You did not waste more than a few liters. It's not even a waste. The problem is when we have it, we waste it. When we don't have it, we complain about it. This is the issue with everything. How many of us, when we have food, and then there is so much of food and there is so much of wastage. And then we don't have and we complain there is no food. But hang on, when you did have, then what did you do? The difficulty is a lot of us, when it comes to issues like, for example, water, we think to ourselves that, okay, by me using a little bit more water, how is it going to affect others? Wallahi, if a million people have to think like you, you have already depleted a whole lake. Do you know that? But you don't realize this. Because people think that, okay, I'm going to spend another maybe, you know, 50 liters extra. What's the big deal? At least I'm paying for it. Pay for it or not pay for it. You and I know at this moment, the whole region is going through a very severe drought. There is a shortage of water, so much so that today's news was saying that the levels in Kariba are very, very low. They are alarming. We need to pray for rain, my brothers and sisters. And the reason why I have chosen this topic is because it's up to us to turn to Allah. We have to thank Him for what He has given us. Whenever have we really sat and thanked Allah? Oh Allah, I got half a slice of bread today. I thank You for that, Ya Allah. Are we ready to do that? I have half a slice of bread today. I'm thanking You for that, Ya Allah. Alhamdulillah. There are people who don't even have that half. The problem with us, you have half a slice of bread. You are oh Allah, I only have half a slice of bread. Look at how we are looking at it. I only have half a slice. It's not enough. Allah says, you thank Me, I give you more. La in shakartum la azidannakum. If you are going to be thankful, I will grant you increase. So that is it. You need to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you are thankful to Allah and you turn to Allah, you watch, the skies will release the water by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Trust me, we pray, we ask Allah for rain. It will be raining before the evening here. If we are sincere and we ask Allah's forgiveness, go back to the story of the Prophet Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. He, in that particular life of his, there was something unique that we learn. There were floods, and there was a stage before the floods where there was no rain. Did you ever know that? There was a stage when there was no rain. Allah says in Surah Nuh, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam was instructed to tell his people,
قُلْ تُسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا.
He says, I told my people, seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is most forgiving. Then he will send you the rain from the heavens. It will come down. Beneficial rain. When? When does the rain come? When you and I become better people, we become closer to Allah. We thank Allah for what He has given us. Thankfulness and gratitude, two main ways of thanking Allah. We are guilty of not doing either of them. What are the two ways? One is to thank Allah by your mouth. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, laka alhamdu, wa laka shukru. All praise is due to you. All thanks is due to you. Laka alhamdu, wa laka shukru. All praise is due to you. All thanks is due to you. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I thank you for what you've given me. I thank you today I was able to turn on the candles in my home. There are people who don't even have candles. We are complaining the generator's not working, the inverter's not working. But did you have a candle? Yes. Did you have a torch on your phone? Yes. There are people who don't even have that. So thank Allah. Oh Allah, I thank you. I thank you for what I have. You know, you took away something. Alhamdulillah, at least you have not taken away everything. Subhanallah. That's one way of thanking Allah. The second thing is to seek or to abstain from the prohibitions that Allah has made clear. When Allah makes something haram, it is prohibited. By us engaging in it, He might prohibit us from something we need. Possible. So this is why Nuh alayhi salam told his people, you want the rain. Yes. If you would like the rain, you need to get onto the right page with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is it? Ask Allah's forgiveness. Quit your bad ways. You have planned a sin. Try your best to keep yourself away from it for the sake of Allah. Oh Allah, help me to stay away from this. And be strong about it. You are a believer. You are not a person who does not believe in Allah. You are going to return to Allah. So ask Allah's protection. Seek His forgiveness. And you find Allah's mercy will open. So a person who thanks Allah by tongue only, but continues to sin, that is not correct gratitude. It's not the right way of doing things. Imagine a person says, oh, you know, I'm so sorry for what I have done. And they do it again. A person comes to you and says, oh, thank you so much for what you've done for me. And behind your back, they are doing something against you. Is that fair? Are they really thankful? We don't even need someone to come to us and say thank you. We just need them to be a good person who does not harm us. It's enough, right or wrong. And sometimes they might say a good word behind our backs. For us, that's enough. But imagine if you were to say thank you very much. You are a good man and thank you. Everything is okay. And behind the back, you are stabbing. How can that be? Why do we do that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We say, oh Allah, I thank you. You gave me eyes, nose, I'm breathing. Everything's okay. I'm living in a country where fruit and vegetables, they just grow like whatever. But oh Allah, I thank you. And at the same time, we go behind the scenes. We are committing adultery. We are drinking alcohol. We are gambling. We are doing so many other haram things. Night clubbing, for example, drugs and so on. Quit it, cut it, for the sake of Allah. Say, oh Allah, forgive me. We need to do this collectively as an ummah. All of us. It's not good enough for me or you, one person, two people to turn and the rest of us don't turn. Or everyone turns and two, three people don't turn. Let us all turn for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Soften your heart. You want to see the rain. Wallahi, your heart has to soften. If your heart is not going to soften, how is the economy going to improve? How is the rain going to come? Rain is known as the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How will it come if we ourselves have not turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My brothers and sisters, as I end my talk today, I would like to encourage yourselves and myself to turn to Allah. May Allah forgive me for my shortcomings. May He forgive you for your shortcomings. Let us look at the gifts of Allah upon us. Let us look at what Allah has bestowed upon us. Let us thank Him for that. And let us promise Allah, oh Allah, I will be a better person. Strengthen me. I really seek forgiveness for the wrong I have done in my life. Ya Allah, strengthen me in a way that you are happy with me. You can improve my conditions and the conditions of the entire ummah and humanity at large. Today we are struggling across the globe. It's important for us to make mention, my brothers and sisters, if you think you are suffering, wallahi, there are people who are really suffering. If you think you are suffering, you are in a paradise.
There are people who would pay anything to be in your shoes, to enjoy the luxuries that you have. There are people out on the globe who are really, really struggling in the true sense. They are homeless, they have no food, they have no drink, they have bombs that are raining on their heads, they have so much of fear and pain, they are losing loved ones, and so much is happening to them. Yet you find them still worshipping Allah and thanking Allah. We are struggling one inch compared to their whole kilometer. One little small inch, and yet it seems like our lives have come to an end. We have no contentment, no happiness. So as I've said, you would like contentment? Yes, turn to Allah. Thank Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide that for you. May Allah grant us all goodness. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad.